Hello, I'm Nona Melkonian with SFGovTV. Along with the League of Women Voters of San Francisco, I'm here to discuss Proposition J, a ballot measure that will be before the voters on Tuesday, November 4th.
Proposition J is an ordinance that would increase the minimum wage for employees who perform work in San Francisco as follows. On May 1st, 2015, the minimum wage would increase to $12.25 per hour. On July 1st, 2016, the minimum wage would increase to $13 per hour. On July 1st, 2017, the minimum wage would increase to $14 per hour. On July 1st, 2018, the minimum wage would increase to $15 per hour. And beginning July 1st, 2019, the minimum wage would increase annually based on inflation. Proposition J would apply to city employees and to employees of the In-Home Support Services Public Authority. Two types of employees would receive a limited increase. Employees under the age of 18 working in a government-subsidized training or apprenticeship program, and employees over age 55 working for nonprofits that provide social welfare services and whose positions are government-subsidized. These employees would receive a minimum wage of $12.25 per hour starting on May 1, 2015, with annual increases starting on July 1, 2016, based on inflation. If you vote yes, you want the city to gradually increase the minimum wage to $15 per hour by July 1, 2018, with increases based on inflation after that. If you vote no, you do not want the city to increase the minimum wage.
I'm here with Jason Elliott, Director of Legislative and Government Affairs at the Mayor's Office and a proponent of Proposition J. We're also joined by Henry Karnilowitz, President of the San Francisco Council of District Merchants Association and an opponent of the measure. Thank you both for being here. I'd like to start with some opening remarks from each of you. Jason, would you like to speak as the proponent?
Thank you, Nona, and thanks to the League of Women Voters for having this forum today. I'll be brief. Proposition J is a measure to raise the minimum wage in San Francisco. Right now, it is $10.74 an hour. If the voters pass this measure, the minimum wage by July of 2018 will be $15 an hour. This measure is necessary, and we hope the voters pass this measure because income inequality in San Francisco is the issue of the day. Families are having to leave San Francisco every day because of affordability concerns, and this is one piece to the puzzle of making San Francisco a city that's more affordable to the 100%.
Thank you.
Okay, so, you know, we don't see it really as helping people out that much, because at the end of the day, what's going to happen is those folks who are earning 15 now, they'll be wanting to increase their income by beyond that. Secondly, is when the cost of doing business is going to increase, a small business has to make some sort of a reasonable profit. And if you have to pay the extra wage, obviously your costs are going to go up. Your cost of the labor is going to go up. So therefore, how do you make the profits? You have to make that adjustment. By doing that, it's going to cost, it can be more expensive to live in a city than what it is right now. At the end of the day, we don't think it's a great benefit. It would be nice if we could get some breaks. Small business got no breaks at all.
Thank you. Jason, do you feel this measure is a compromise between employees and owners of small and large businesses in San Francisco?
Sure. This measure is certainly a compromise. There were a number of measures that were proposed earlier this year. Ultimately, there was one consensus measure placed on the ballot by Mayor Ed Lee and supported by the entire Board of Supervisors. There are a number of organizations around the city that are supportive of this minimum wage. Does everyone think this is the perfect minimum wage? Of course not, my friend. Henry just expressed some of the concerns that some district merchants and neighborhood associations might have with the measure. But this is a minimum wage that takes stair steps up from the current minimum wage, where we are now at $10.74, as I mentioned, with a gradual increases year over year, culminating in a $15 an hour minimum wage in 2018. This is a very gradual stair step up to $15 an hour compared to what some of the earlier proposals would have been. We feel like this is a measure that is fair to workers that are earning the minimum wage, fair to businesses who have to pay it, fair to San Franciscans who are trying to live here and stay in San Francisco despite some of the affordability concerns.
Thank you. Henry, would you like to respond to Jason's comments?
Yeah, this wage is an entry-level wage. And so for entry-level, for somebody who's not qualified to go into a job at this wage, It's going to be tough for a small business to be able to bring people in from that level. They'd want to have more qualified people to come in. So, and again, getting back to the reaching out to everybody, that really there was, but there wasn't consensus on the small business end of it. I will say this, most small businesses are afraid that the consumer out there is going to be like, hey, look, you know, if that's the way you feel, we're not going to come and shop at your store, or shop at your restaurant or whatever. So they've sort of accepted for what's going to happen, unfortunately. But at the end of the day, what's going to happen is costs are going to go up, and it's going to be a more expensive city. And so the people who are getting minimum wage now, when it's all said and done, I've seen other economists who have come out and said, you know, there's not going to be a change, really, because just the cost is going to go up. And so how much you're making, you're going to be paying more, so you're not going to have such a great benefit.
Thank you. Henry's got some concerns about the cost of living.
Sure.
Do you feel that there will be some increases in the cost of living in San Francisco?
Well, proponents of this measure, we share Henry's worries about the cost of living in San Francisco. That's precisely why we've proposed this in the first place. The World Bank has recent data from as early as June of this year, as recently as June of this year. San Francisco's income inequality is on par with developing nations. And we need to do something to help the people that are on the lower end of that inequality. This measure, if passed, will mean raises for some 60,000 people working in San Francisco. These people are earning minimum wage or just above it now, and they're trying to survive in San Francisco. If this minimum wage passes, people in certain industries, including those that Henry represents, workers in those industries, low-wage workers in those industries, will be taking home substantial amounts of money more per week. And when I say substantial, I mean perhaps $200 a week in some cases. In the retail trade industry, for example, $185 per week more at full implementation in 2018. A worker will be taking home $185 more a week. Well, $185 more might not be a lot for someone earning $150,000 or $200,000 a year. But for someone who is trying to survive in San Francisco, maybe not even raise a family, but survive as a single individual, it sounds, as crazy as this is, the federal benefits thresholds are actually lower than what the minimum wage is, meaning you can be living in San Francisco, working full-time, and be earning too much to qualify for some federal benefits. We need to raise the minimum wage and help these people out.
Thank you. Henry, any thoughts on Jason's comments?
Yes, absolutely. The other thing is what, as Jason just said, that, you know, it's going to be the minimum wage for San Franciscans. We're going to have competition from people from outside of San Francisco because they will not be getting the minimum wage. Let's make this $15 across the board everywhere. Then everybody's on the same page, but we're not. And then we also have, you got your online businesses, you got your Amazons, and you got your Googles that are delivering groceries today, you know, and we're competing with those folks. So it's making harder and harder for us to even survive, let alone to pay more. We're absolutely all for making a better, you know, income for everybody. We really are. I think it's, you know, I've seen where people do get the minimum wage, and I don't like that myself. But again, what I'm talking about is the entry level. You'll find the majority of people in small business don't pay. They pay more than 15 already, but it's the entry level. And we think we should have gotten a break in that, and we didn't.
Thank you both for your comments and your time today. I'd like to use a little bit of time for final remarks. Henry, would you like to give your remarks first?
Yes. You know, I don't think that this income is going to really help people when it comes to housing. Rents are skyrocketing up. Small business doesn't have any rent control. Our rents are also going up by way, way more than your residential rents. Lastly, we realize that we probably have a little chance of winning this or even coming close to it. So my final word out there to the public is go and shop local. Think about your small businesses. Get off your little email account or your mobile device and order everything from Amazon and Google and so on. Shop local. I urge you, please shop local. Think about what small businesses and what it does to the community. And it's at the end of the day, it's our community and what our wonderful city is because of that. Thank you.
Thank you. Jason, any final remarks?
Sure. I know this is supposed to be a debate. I couldn't agree more with Henry's closing statement. Please go shop local. We say that to all San Franciscans. Supporting neighborhood corridors is what makes this city so vibrant. So I couldn't agree more with that. Just a final word on the minimum wage. Henry has raised some concerns that some small businesses and neighborhood merchants have with the cost of doing business. Those are real concerns, and we tried as best we could to address those by making this a gradual minimum wage that stair steps to $15 an hour over the next 4 years. I'll just, final thought, this is just one step towards solving income inequality. This measure alone will not make housing affordable to everyone who wants to live in San Francisco, and we're not under the illusion that it will. But it is a good first step. This is the first thing we can do of hopefully many more things, measures we can work together on to make San Francisco a place that's affordable to everyone who wants to live and work here.
Thank you.
Thanks.
We hope that this discussion has been informative. For more information on this and other ballot measures in this year's election, please visit the San Francisco Elections website at sfelection.org. Remember, early voting is available at City Hall Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. You can also vote at City Hall on the two weekends before Election Day. And if you don't vote early, be sure to vote on Tuesday, November 4th.